In this tutorial, we will learn how to configure NS records for a managed DNS domain within DNS Made Easy. A note before we start, creating NS records can be a very complex and involved process. Only experienced DNS administrators should attempt using NS records for management of their domains in part or in full. Improper configuration of your NS records can result in loss of some or all traffic to your domain. There are two reasons you would want to add NS records under a domain within DNS Made Easy. The first reason is to delegate part of your domain to use different name servers. The second is to split DNS traffic for your domain between DNS Made Easy and other name servers. We will first show the steps necessary to delegate part of your domain to other name servers. In this example, we will delegate subdomain.example.com to myns1.example.com and myns2.example.com. To begin, click on Manage DNS under the DNS tab in the main menu. If you have recently modified the domain you want to work with, you can choose it from the Recently Updated Domains list. If your domain is not listed, enter your domain name in the Manage DNS search box. For this example, we will be working with the domain example.com. Click on the Records tab if it is not already the active tab. Please note, you will need to ensure that the proper A records are in place for the name servers you are adding. In our example, myns1.example.com and myns2.example.com will need to have the proper A records created under example.com. As you can see, since example.com is configured in DNS Made Easy, we have already configured the A records for our new name servers. If you need help with modifying A records, please view the video tutorial, Working with A Records. Scroll down to the NS records grid within example.com's record settings and click the plus sign associated with it. Enter the name of your subdomain. For this example, we will be delegating subdomain.example.com, so we will enter subdomain in the name field. In the value field, enter the name of the first name server you want to delegate your subdomain to. We are using myns1. Hit submit to confirm your changes. myns2.example.com will be our next NS record to set up. In the name field, enter the value for your next NS record. Repeat the previous steps to configure myns2. Please note, the same rules that apply to CNAME values also apply here. We will be ending our values with a dot, since the name servers are outside of the domain that we are working with. Now, any DNS lookups for subdomain.example.com will be handled by the name servers myns1.example.com and myns2.example.com. We are now going to discuss the steps necessary to split DNS traffic for your domain between DNS Made Easy's name servers and other name servers. These are the steps involved in splitting DNS traffic for your domain that we will be detailing in this tutorial. Step 1. Create a transfer ACL within DNS Made Easy. Step 2. Apply the transfer ACL to the domain or domains within DNS Made Easy. Step 3. Configure your secondary name server to request zone information from DNS Made Easy. Step 4. Add the necessary NS records within DNS Made Easy. And step 5, update your name servers at the registrar. Step 1, creating a transfer ACL within DNS Made Easy. A transfer ACL allows name servers to request zone information from DNS Made Easy name servers that would otherwise be prohibited. Select Transfer ACL AXFR under the Advanced tab in the main menu. Click the plus sign associated with the AXFR ACL's grid. This opens the Add AXFR window. Be certain to give the new ACL a readily identifiable name. For this example, we are entering My Secondary Name Servers. Next, add the IP address of your name servers that will request zone transfers from DNS Made Easy. For the sake of this demonstration, we are using a non-public IP address, but you should follow along with the IP you'd like to configure. Click Submit to confirm your changes. You can see that the new ACL has been added to the AXFR ACL's grid. You can add and modify these IPs at any time by clicking on the ACL to make any changes. Step 2. Applying the Transfer ACL to the domain or domains within DNS Made Easy. With the new ACL in place, please return to the Manage DNS section and reopen the settings for your domain. Click the Settings tab if it is not already the active tab, and click the drop-down next to Zone Transfer AXFR ACL to select the ACL we just created. Click the Save button to confirm your changes, and you will be greeted with a success window letting you know that the ACL has been applied to your domain. Once you've applied the ACL, click the Name Servers tab. Take note of the FQDN and IP address within the AXFR server grid. You're going to need this information in the next step, as the AXFR server is the server your name servers or other DNS providers will be using to pull zone data from DNS Made Easy. Step 3. Configuring your secondary name server to request zone information from DNS Made Easy. You will need to configure additional name servers or DNS providers to receive notifies and pull zone data from DNS Made Easy using the IP that was found within the AXFR server grid under the Name Servers tab. Unfortunately, since this step is performed outside of the DNS Made Easy interface, we cannot show it to you in detail. If you require assistance with completing this step, either consult the documentation for your other DNS provider or contact their support team. Step 4. Adding the necessary NS records within DNS Made Easy. We will create NS records for our additional name servers. Click the Records tab and scroll down to the NS Records grid. Just as before, click the plus sign to open the Add NS Records window. Leave the name field blank this time, since we are planning on splitting traffic for the main domain. In the Value field, enter the name of your first name server. To reduce queries against your domain, set the TTL to a higher number, as these name servers change very infrequently. We are using 86,400 seconds. Click Submit to confirm creation. Repeat this process for subsequent name servers and close the window. Just like before, the same rules apply here as apply to CNAME values. So in this case, we will be ending our values with a dot, since the name servers are outside of the domain that we are working with. ns1.example100.com and ns2.example100.com. Step 5. Updating your name servers at the registrar. At your registrar, you will want to add delegation of the new name servers along with the DNS Made Easy name servers already listed. Please note, since this process is performed outside of the DNS Made Easy control panel, you will need to consult with your registrar's support team if you require assistance. Your domain is now configured to split DNS traffic between different providers. Whenever a change is made in the control panel or the API, we will send a notify to the IPs listed in your ACL, so all of the name servers will always be up to date and synchronized. For our full support knowledge base, please visit http://support.dnsmadeeasy.com. For more tutorials and lessons on using DNS Made Easy, please visit http://help.dnsmadeeasy.com.